everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to use the root test to determine whether or not a series converges or diverges. And in this particular case, we've been given the series 3 to the k divided by the quantity k plus 1 raised to the k power. And we've been asked to determine whether or not this series converges or diverges when k starts at 1 and tends towards infinity. So what I've done here is taken a screen grab of the root test section of the table of convergence tests that I have on my website. And what it tells us is it outlines how to use the root test. But the root test is, despite that this might seem a little complicated, pretty simple. It just allows us to do some cool simplification when we have a specific type of series. What we're looking for with the root test is a couple of things. We want to make sure that every single term in our series is raised to the power of k or n or whatever your variable is, right? Every term in our series is raised to the power of k. That's a dead giveaway that we should be using the root test, because what we do when we use the root test, and let me just set this up, we'll take the limit as k goes to infinity of the series. We go ahead and write out the series. Quantity k plus 1 raised to the k. We take the entire series, and this is what's cool about the root test. We take the entire series and we raise it to the power of 1 divided by k, or whatever your variable is. Basically, what we're doing is we're taking the square root of the entire series, or not the square root, but the kth root or the nth root or whatever of the entire series. And what that allows us to do is simplify these exponents, which is pretty cool. So when every single term in your series is, in this case, raised to the power of k, and you take the kth root of the entire series, it's going to go ahead and cancel for you all of these exponents, right? So it's going to cancel all of these exponents here, right? Because here, for k and 1 over k, right, you'll end up with k times 1 over k. The k's cancel and you're just left with 1. So all of those exponents go away. And when we simplify now what we have left, right, we're going to simplify and we're going to get some number. We'll call it L. So when we get L, what the root test tells us is that if L is less than 1, right, if L is less than 1, then the series converges absolutely. If L is greater than 1, then the series diverges. And of course, if L is equal to 1, then the root test is inconclusive and we'll have to use another test. So again, all you're looking for is that each term in your original series here is raised to the power of k, or whatever it is that is the variable you're working with. So what we're left with here is the limit as k goes to infinity. Now that we've canceled our exponents, we just have 3 over k plus 1, right? And we can now very quickly see, if we plug in infinity for k, the denominator here is going to get very, very, very large, right? And as we know, whenever we're using these convergence tests and we get really comfortable with this, whenever the denominator of a fraction gets very large, that means that the entire fraction is going to tend towards zero, because, you know, go ahead and plug in 3 divided by 1, you know, million or 1 billion in your calculator, and you're going to see that it's an extremely small number. It's going to approach zero. So this whole function here will be zero, which means we'll get L equals zero, okay? So now that we have L equals zero, we can go back up here to our root test screenshot, and we know that the series converges if L is less than 1. In this case, L is less than 1. It's 0, which is less than 1. So we can confirm that this series converges absolutely, right? So we'll go ahead and say converges absolutely by the root test. By root test. And that tells us the convergence for this series. So that's it. Pretty simple. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!